Okay, so I've been looking at this diagram here, the ring diagram, and I think I've got this thing about built. Signal controllers, what I did was I used an ASC3. Let me show you how I did this here. Parameters. And I came in and I set this thing up so that in this I used three rings. In their document, they use phase 1, 2, and 3 in the first ring. In the second ring, they use 4 and 7 alternating. And in the third ring, they use 5 and 6 alternating. I set the compatibility. So then under controller or coordination, I set up all the splits exactly how they have them here. So 29, 26, 24, 37, 30, or 42, and then 32, 47. So those splits are all set. I did the coordinated phase for each ring. I did ring lag by 55 seconds, which is reference to the start of the coordinated phase that comes first in the sequence. So that 55 seconds has shifted both of these rings. So now when I play this thing, and this may go a little slow to get this loaded here, I'll probably fast forward this portion, but once I get this fired up, I'm gonna go into quick mode to get this thing into chord. Okay, so we're in coordination now. And this thing has worked sort of funky. Now, the really good part is, I'm gonna stop this about 30 seconds in this no man's land here and just show that everything's matching up. Let me go. That'll be fine. So I'm at 35 seconds in my cycle length, and what I should have according to this is I should have green for phase 2, phase 6, and phase 7. And when I look up at this controller, it's green for phase 2, 6, and 7. So I'm going to play this some more. I'll stop it when I get to about 60 seconds. So I'm at 50 seconds in the local cycle. Everything went green, so this is exactly where I need to be, so on 60. If I draw a line on this chart down at 60, it should be green for 3, 4, and 5, which it is in this controller. So everything's working based on this design here that they had in this paper with this timing ring. So I think I've gotten it all. Now what I'll do is I'll show the full effect to show that I do indeed have this thing working. So I'm going to stop. I'll make this large. I'll stop this simulation. And I'm going to go to simulation parameters. And I'll bump this up to maximum so you can see this thing work. So again, this controller, everything is working according to the design of the article that Tom sent. And right now it's in deduct. I'm going to get fast forwarding just so that I can get into coordination. Good. And now when I'm running this controller here, it sort of works, but it's also sort of not good. So I'm looking and watching my southbound, and it looks like the left turn is almost more coordinated than the southbound through, which is not doing well. So as I'm watching here, actually that was not good. So here comes southbound through. It should come cleanly on through, but it cuts them off up at the north end. Northbound at the bottom release and gets that signal just about where it needs to be. Get as many through as I can. Let's end up storing a few. So I think this thing is working the way that's intended. These are the 2035 volumes that I'm recording. So if I zoom out on 2035, we're still going to expect queuing on either side. So at the south end with Calusa, there's no signal at Calusa either. I haven't put it in yet. Coordinating the 2 8-phase intersections next to this 3-ring double crossover intersection is going to be a little tricky. It's not hard. I think I got through the harder of the two parts. But this was a start to get things going, and so as you're looking at this, we're still queuing up beyond the link length, which means that this is not going to be an accurate simulation. So we still have heavy queuing, so The question is, it fixed the intersection down below. Sort of is looking better. So, anyhow, this was a ton of work to get this thing going here. So, I think that we've got that about set for what we can show for just a brief review.